Welcome to the DevExpress Learn Now series, quick tutorials to help you get started using DevExpress controls. XAF programmers are often required to maintain a legacy database instead of building an application from scratch. In this video, we'll demonstrate the database-first approach and show you how to use the XPO Data Model Designer to create an XAF application that is based on the existing database. Please note that the XPO Data Model Designer requires Visual Studio 2010 or a later version, so let's take a look. Let's start from a new XAF solution. In the Visual Studio menu, choose File, New, Project. In the New Project dialog, select the XAF Cross-Platform Application Template. Change the solution name to My Solution and click OK. Right-click the Business Objects folder located in the MySolution.module project. Choose Add New Item. In the invoked Add New Item dialog, choose the DXperience ORM version 12.1 Data Model Wizard template located in the DevExpress category. Set the new item's name to MySolutionDataModel.xpo and click Add. You'll see that the MySolutionDataModel.xpo item is added and the wizard dialog is invoked. In the invoked wizard dialog, choose Map to an existing database and click Next. Now, specify connection settings to the database. As you can see, the wizard supports multiple database systems. The Provider Combo box specifies the required database type. In this video, we'll use the Northwind Traders demo database that is in the Access 97 format. This database is shipped with DXperience 12.1 and installed here by default. Choose this file and click Next. In this wizard step, a list of tables that are available in the chosen database is displayed. You can select all tables or several specific tables. For instance, let's select the Customers and Orders tables. Click Next to close the wizard. The generated data model will be shown in the XPO Data Model Designer. Here we can make certain customizations. You can see that the names of persistent classes and their properties match the names of selected tables and their columns. In the Northwind Traders database, the table names are in plural form. Let's change class names, customers to customer, and orders to order. To rename a class or its property, select it in the designer and change the name in the properties window. Let's save changes and close the designer. The generated code files are available in the Solution Explorer in the Business Objects / My Solution Data Model Code folder. You see the customer.designer.cs file contains the customer XPO class that is mapped to the customers table. Persistent properties are automatically created for each table's column. Similarly, the order.designer.cs file contains the order class mapped to the orders table. These code behind files should not be modified manually. Now let's add some XAF attributes to the generated code. Open the customer.cs file that contains the customizable part of the customer class. Decorate the class with the default class options and image name attributes. Pass BO contact to image name attribute. As a result, the customer object will be added to the navigation and the BO contact icon from the built-in library will be associated with this object. Do the same in the order.cs file. We'll use the BO order icon for the order class. If we want our application to connect the same database that was used for the data model generation, then we should change the connection string, both for Windows Forms and ASP.NET applications. Copy the valid connection string from the auto-created business objects / My Solution Data Model Code / connectionhelper.cs file. Open the Windows Forms configuration file. Uncomment one of the connection string keys and paste the connection string value. Do the same for the ASP.NET configuration file. Let's run the Windows Forms to see the result. You can see the customer and order objects in the navigation. List and detail views are created for these objects. Note that the one-to-many association between these objects is correctly handled. A similar UI is created for the ASP.NET application. Thanks for watching. Let's see what develops.